When you get down to 10 big blinds, all you can do is push fold. Well, there's almost a religion revolving around this. People take this for so granted that no one seems to challenge and question this. So in this video, I'll show you just how wrong this whole statement is. Then another one will be play tight early. Sure, a lot of people are doing this. A lot of very successful people are basically folding through the early game. And yeah, you can definitely play like this. And you don't make a big mistake by playing tight early. But you're also leaving a lot of value at the tables. There's a bunch of ways you can exploit the regulars because they play the tight early game in such a similar way always that you can find spots where you can definitely take advantage and take pretty good edges from regulars. And you can also improve your edges versus fish with a few moves. Then another myth. In sit and goes, the vast majority of your money is made in the bubble. Sure, a lot of it is made in the bubble. But you should definitely not underestimate the ITM game and heads up play. Sure, if you want to be a successful sit and go player, you definitely have to know the bubble game. And you definitely have to know how you can exploit the fear people have in their game. And how you can exploit, if you have a big stack on the bubble, how you can exploit and just run over the bubble. Sure, you have to know that. But definitely, there's a lot of money to be made when you get down to three-handed, if it's a single nine-man tournament or heads-up. There's a lot of value to be had there, as well as before the bubble. We'll be focusing on that in one of the videos. Then another funny one. When you're getting 2-to-1 odds, you can't fold anymore. I don't know who came up with this in the first place, but this is just absolutely wrong. If anybody ever tells you that, oh, you're getting 2-to-1, you can't really fold anymore, he's never done the math. Don't listen to him. I'll show you in this very video how very wrong this can be. And there's gonna be more. But for now, this is Sit and Go Mythbusters. Let's begin. Let's take a very common spot. We'll analyze it with Mr. Sit and Go Wizard. We'll analyze a new game. We'll be on a full 9-man table, blinds at 100-200, and it's down to 6 players who each have exactly 10 big blinds. This is not going to be a realistic scenario because the stacks do not add up to 13.5k, but it doesn't matter. The ICM is still very valid. So, it folds to us on the small blind, and we pick up Queen-9 offsuit. So, we'll be setting the edge to 0, and okay, if the villain is calling us 13% of the time with these hands, shoving is plus 1%, very big edge, so it would be an easy shove, right? Okay, there aren't too many people who would be this tight, so we'll be more realistic. Let's give him the very classic any ace, any pair range, which includes King Jack offsuit and King 9 suited, as well as Queen Jack suited. Not at all an unrealistic range if you see that your villain is shoving with any kind of frequency. Okay, so the diff here is 0.24. That's plus EV. We can't shove any two. We can only shove these hands that are marked in blue because they play well enough against the villain's calling range. See, and we don't pick up the big blind often enough for an any two card shove to be profitable. So it's plus EV, plus 0.24, so we should be shoving, right? Well, you can shove, but is it really the only way you can play this hand? And most importantly, is it the best, the most optimal way of playing this hand?